and pumpkin spice tea. It's very calming, guaranteed to soothe the nerves.
Well, Flynn, I think you're the one who should be drinking it.
Oh, no, ma'am. I can't do that. You hired me yesterday, remember?
Sit. And if that doesn't help, maybe a nice dose of cod liver oil will cure your disposition.
Maybe just a sip.
Now, Twink. Some of the guests here at my boarding house are a little eccentric. You mustn't believe any of the rumors you may have heard. There is no dead bodies here, that I know of. This house isn't haunted, much, and there is absolutely no buried treasure put there by that murderous Captain Schnook. Understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Got it. Now, you said this was birch bark and raspberry tea leaves?
As Mysterious Number 5, and I'll thank you to remember that. My professional pen name.
Pen name? Were you in prison?
No, you simpleton.
Mr. Richards, drink your tea.
I, ma'am, I'm a writer. The greatest purveyor of prose is the immortal Edgar Allan Poe.
So you write words on paper? What have you written? Anything I've read?
Well, not yet, but soon, madam, soon. As soon as I find the inspiration, I shall be the greatest.
Drink your tea.
Hurry, can't you see him injured, possibly fatally?
Drink your tea, and if that isn't helpful, maybe a nice dose of cod liver oil.
I've been poisoned!
Did I make it too strong?
You did this to me, which I'll kill you for that! Too late. I die.
Very good, Mr. Richards. You die better than anyone I know of.
I killed him. Murderer.
Did you evidently, didn't I?
Rather morbid, if you ask me. You're always running around here, either trying to kill yourself or get killed. Why can't you write happy stories about pink petunias, bunny rabbits, or snowflakes?
I, madam, am a creature of the night, of darkness and destruction, of murder and mayhem, of evil and...
Poppycock! No one is evil unless they want to be. All you need is a little motherly guidance. And, well, maybe a nice dose of cod liver oil. I'll have Tweenie bring you a plate of cookies. That should cure your disposition.
I don't want a cookie. I'm going to study my art. Into the alley with me. Away!
In my brain, don't forget your galoshes!
If I may quote a phrase, madam, twaddle.
Well, that wasn't very polite. I hope you catch a cold. Then you'll have to take his comment for all.
Where is the body?
Mr. Richards, I threw him out.
You threw him out? Just like that?
Of course. I have no use for that man.
I suppose not. Dead men aren't very useful.
And I don't want you serving him at dinner tonight either.
Oh, no, ma'am. I was planning on serving pot roast. What was that?
Oh, dear. It sounds as though Martha's catching another cold. Oh, I do so hope she gets worse.
You want her to get worse?
Of course. Having the sniffles is such a common thing to have. Now, if she can work up a nice case of the leprosy, or double pneumonia, ooh, or both at once. Excellent. She's getting there.
I think I'll go make some more tea.